Good morning students, this class we will discuss about Johansson microcator. Johansson microcator is a type of mechanical comparator. This comparator invented by a Swedish engineer named H. Abramson, which was later introduced and manufactured by a Sweden company, C.H. Johnson Limited. Next we discuss what are the parts available in the Johansson microcator. A metallic strip is twisted and fixed between the two ends. The two side S-type elbow provisions they are given. The metallic strip is connected between the two ends. Longitudinal movement will cause the central portion of the strip to rotate. One end of the strip is fixed to an adjustable cantilever and the other end is fixed to the spring elbow. So what type of component objects you have to check, we have to move that spring elbow. So based on that plunger, it will be move up and down directions. So based on that needle, it will be show that what type of deviations occur during that process. Spring elbow is connected to a plunger, it moves up and down directions. Elbow holds the slit washer at the bottom where the measuring plunger is mounted. Both sides of the elbow hold that bell crank lever and the cantilever strip. So the component have to check that time the bell crank lever, it will be moved to left and right side directions. So based on, so we have noticed that value in that particular scale. Twisted strip is fastened between the bell crank lever and the cantilever strip. So that strip is flexible in nature. It is made up of Pasper branch. Metal strip at the center carries a light pointer made up of glass. Next we discuss how the Johansson microcutter is working. When you have to start the process before, you have to check that standard specimen. Standard specimens keep in that position and you have to maintain that needle in that zero position. Then you have to remove that standard specimen and what type of component you have to check that respective specimen have to keep in that position. Then you have to move that bell crank lever to left to right side directions. In that vertical movement, either upward or downward in the plunger, is transmitted through that elbow to that bell crank lever. So based on that what type of surface irregularities it's available, it will be vary that needle, it will be move to left and right side in that scale. The bell crank lever moves either left or right side respect to that vertical movement of the plunger. So how that plungers it will be act, so based on that that needle, it will be move left to right directions. Displacement of bell crank lever makes the strip to twist or untwist. So the twist or untwist, untwist means stretching to base on that surface conditions of that component, which is fastened to that cantilever strip at that opposite end. Perforated strips are used in this comparator. So this reasons behind to prevent that excessive stress. Glass pointer placed in the center of the twisted strip start rotates either in the clockwise or anticlockwise directions. This rotation is directly proportional to change in length of strip due to stretching caused by that plunger movement. The plunger movement is to based on that surface appearance of that component. Deflection of the glass pointer is recorded by that calibrated scale parallel to the pointer. Magnification of Johansson microcutter is expressed. Magnification equal to d theta divided by dl. D theta divided by dl is directly proportional to 1 divided by nw squared, where L, length of the metal strip, N, number of tans on the metal strip, W, width of the metal strip. Magnification of this instrument depends upon the length of the strip and the number of twists in the twisted strip. So we get obtained better magnification. The twisted strip must be smaller in dimension. So Johansson microcutter has accuracy plus or minus 1%. So this device is suitable for that mass production. Same identical component I have checked quickly. So these are the main advantages of that Johansson microcutter. Next we discuss what are the advantages of Johansson microcutter. Johansson microcutter small and compact in size. It's a portable device, so easier to transfer from one location to another location. It's very convenient to one. It's suitable for compare that component, same identical components. It's suitable. They are maintained controlled laboratory environmental conditions to get that precision and accuracy value of that respective components. No external power source required to perform that operation.